Birds come in many shapes and sizes, but some of the ones you might be most familiar with are finches and sparrows. And these seed and nut eaters actually might be very indicative of what happened when the birds first evolved. A new study used DNA phylogenetics and ecological studies to try and establish what the first birds were probably like. And what it found is they were probably herbivorous, and this means they would have spent a lot of time foraging. Now, if you've seen foraging birds, especially some of the ones that spend a lot of time on the ground, they can take off very, very quickly. And that's essentially because they're under risk of predation by other predators. And the first birds could have also been under the same kind of predation, especially by other kinds of non-flying relatives of theirs, such as animals like Sinornithosaurus, which could have glided, but definitely not flown because it would have been too heavy. So essentially, this shift into herbivory in the dinosaurs very near the bird family tree essentially forced them to start being able to take off faster, as any animals that were able to flap to essentially escape quicker would have been able to help them fly and then eventually fly very well. So essentially, this paper is suggesting that because the birds became herbivorous fairly early in their lineage, it actually helped them to achieve flight, because they would have needed to essentially start flapping for escape earlier on, and then any birds that should flap even better and start to fly would have had a better chance of survival, and then continuing onward and onward, until we have the very successful flight mechanisms of modern birds. But that's not all that they found. And that's because birds actually have a very specialized digestive system, which they do go into the specific genes that it gets into in this paper. However, I'm not fully a gene expert, so I can't really explain all of this to you. But they do have a very complex digestive system, which is more efficient than other animals which also eat plant matter. And so essentially, this kind of a more efficient gut would have helped them to essentially lighten their load and maximize their foraging time. This means that they first got more bang for their buck when foraging. So a bird with this more complex digestive system would have essentially needed to forage for less time than other birds because it would have gotten the same amount of energy. The other part means, though, that they could have essentially had a smaller digestive tract. And having a smaller digestive tract means they also could have still taken off faster. So it does seem like this shift to herbivory in the theropod dinosaurs did eventually lead to the birds. And so they may not have been quite as related to some of the animals like the dromaeosaurs that we may have thought. Although they are still closely related, it's just essentially there's a lot of the fossil record we may be missing.